Well, greetings, folks, and welcome to another episode in the Planetary Persuader. I am Kozmic Kev, your host, and I want to wish everyone today a happy autumnal equinox. So, if you are on the West Coast, that actually happened yesterday, fairly early in the morning, 7:22 a.m., so that happened Thursday, but you know, we're still, it's the 23rd. For a lot of people, that was the first day of Libra when they were born, so we're still celebrating, and you know what? Even though it's one day into the fall already here in the Northern Hemisphere, we still have more light than darkness. Why? Because light is stronger than darkness, and I just think that's always a nice thought to begin your week. Now, we've had some planetary shifts. One of the best ones is Mercury is direct this whole week. That happened late Wednesday night. So Mercury direct in Virgo, wonderful, wonderful. Something else is happening. That is, we've got Venus going into Scorpio, and it just did. So, you know, or will at, you know, 7 in the morning, Friday morning, 7:51, something like that. You know, that's also Vedic Libra. So, I mean, one thing I want to express is that the comma, the juiciness of love is way more evident now. You're feeling it, you know. There's it's almost like a second spring or something. There's a sort of randy appreciation of amour. Okay. Now, what other fun, exciting things are happening this week in the world of astrology? Well, In other words here, other terms, I think Mars is heading down into the way of Capricorn too. Now, when does that happen exactly? Boy, so that is on, I believe, Monday, shall I say? I should know all these things. Well, it's actually Tuesday at 1:08 a.m. So Tuesday, 1:08 a.m., folks, we've got Mars in Capricorn. Now, you know, like, Mars in Capricorn is a pretty exalted place to be for Mars, because it puts Mars in that midheaven position, which is career and leadership, and it's also, you know, a good place for commanding things, making things go a certain way. So That's another fun tidbit about this week. Let's see what else is in store. I know that Friday we have a new moon, so next Friday, a week from now, we're going to have a new moon, and that happens just a little after midnight at 12:52 a.m., so it's really like Thursday night, so in a lot of ways this should be, the new moon is also part of this week's horoscope in a sense, so but we're in a waning moon period this week, folks, and so we're really finishing off stuff. That new moon's going to be in the nakshatra of Hasta, and You know, a hosta is a combination of all the mental energies. And so if you got to do your thinking work and you're working on brainstorming, hosta is a good one, because hosta is ruled both by moon and it's within the sign of Virgo in Vedic astrology. You know, and sidereal, as it actually is in the sky. Say, where is the new moon going to be? Well, it's going to be a constellation of Virgo. Yeah, I can see it because it's dark. But yeah, in Western astrology, we call it the Libra new moon. So, without any further ado and messing around, sign by sign, here we go. Yes, beginning with you, Aries. This is it. Now, greetings, Aries. Welcome to your horoscope. So, what's happening for you is we've got a shift of Mars energy this week. So you're going from the ninth house, which is sort of like a spiritual quest, to the 10th house, where it's where you're assuming leadership responsibility, and there's more of a passion to engage with the public. And so, and in whatever your best skills and talents are. Now, Libra time is about the lover. And so, you know, we've got Jupiter and Sun conjoining each other right now. It's a beautiful thing. That means this is a very fortunate time. And I think part of this brainstorming that's about to take place, it's about doing good things. And man, we need more good things. We really do. Because it lifts up everyone's load. So having everybody do better is got to be good. It's got to be great. We have Mercury still in the sixth house. So you're working on getting organized, you're working on getting healthier, and I mean really fall is the most important time to watch your health. We're starting out the weekend, this as of the 23rd, with the moon in Cancer. So, you know, the weekend begins with moon in Cancer, so home things, things dealing with the emotions, Sunday morning, moon will go into Leo in Western astrology. On and on it goes through the week. Okay. You know, learn to negotiate, learn to appreciate your mate. I think that's a good message for Aries this week. Okay, we're going into the land of my friend Taurus here. So greetings, Taurus. Welcome to your horoscope. So what are we looking at? Well, what we're making happen here is you have Venus getting out into your seventh house now. And so, and I always feel like in Western astrology, you know, not a lot of people, because it's sort of like Venus and Scorpio is debilitated, because, you know, Scorpio's Mars rule, which is sort of opposite of Venus, but, you know, in Vedic astrology, most Venus and Scorpios and Libra, it's actually very exalted and good. And this is the other thing I don't quite understand, is because, you know, water signs in Western astrology all rule the imagination and emotional sensitivity. And in that is creativity, you know, and especially in Pisces and Scorpio. But there is in Cancer too, as long as they're not too sentimental. No, and and so since Scorpio's key phrase in modern astrology is I create, you know, you're creating a relationship right now, Taurus. You know, you're creating, and like if you were singing in a duet or in a band or something right now, the whole music thing goes better. Everything you do that is involved with engaging other people actually is going to go better, and that is nice. You still have Mercury in the fifth house. So, you know, you've got play and love on your mind, but here's the warning. It's like you have to pay attention to your health. This is a year where you cannot ignore your health at all. Jupiter's going through your sixth house, and it's, you know, it's going to account for stuff. So, hey, wait, whoa, what are you doing? You know, that's, we want to make it good now. So let's be good to ourselves, create that culture, and then we're in Gemini. So, greetings, Gemini. Welcome to your horoscope. All right, so this is generally thought of as a wonderful time for you. Yeah. Because the Sun and Jupiter are transiting your fifth house. So there is this tremendous expansion of the pursuit of happiness, pursuit of teaching as far as leadership goes, paying attention to your children, if you have children. That's really the biggest one in the fifth house is your kids. And any kind of creative project you're doing, love affairs, relationships for the fun of it, you know. And I think in the terms of fun, mostly like heart connection, not just false made up force fun, but you're really feeling it. So, I mean, I think most of this week's going to be like that. I mean, I see this weekend, especially Friday, Saturday, good days to make money, you know, good days to look at things like that. Venus going into your sixth house. Well, you know, get a nice outfit for work or something. You know, the weather's getting chillier. You might, you know, need to change your wardrobe a little bit, that kind of thing. Okay. Well, hello, Cancer. And welcome to your horoscope. Okay. So we're starting out with the moon this weekend in your first house. So you're feeling your emotion. And, you know, the funny thing about the Libra Sun period for Cancers is, like, this is where we really, this is a fourth house transit. You're very much in touch with your emotions. In Western astrology, air signs are hard on water. Can anybody tell me why? So they tend to intellectualize everything and are rational, and a lot of them will just kind of poo-poo intuition, things like that. Okay, that's one. Very good. But the real one, you know, it's just so much more mundane is that, you know, air can dry up water. And, you know, when we intellectualize everything, it kind of ruins some of the just spontaneous mirth that happens from just going with it, you know. And I think fire signs and water signs are much better at just kind of going with it in some ways, you know. They represent both the extremes of the feminine and the extremes of the masculine. So, you know, whereas air and earth are both more balanced. They both contain male and female within them as elements. Get into more of that, you know. That's my Western astrology interpretation. Fourth house is all about foundation. It's about family. It's about family history. You want to learn about what your older relatives did in the past? Good time for that. Yeah. Good time to really explore that. And with Mercury direct now in your third house, communication is good. You understand things like you never have before. And with this new moon coming up, late Thursday night, really early Friday morning, next week, as you know, next week, but you understand what I'm saying, when we get to the 30th. I see it as a time of epiphanies for you. And I think a good time to honor your mom, honor your mother, honor your tribe, your tribal elders, people that you admire. And from that place, you build a foundation of security and move on in the world. Well, hello, Leo. All right, so Leo, you're all about opening up the heart. Now, Virgo time for you was mostly about the second house, financial issues. Things are starting to stabilize, you know, right now. And so maybe your finances aren't going to be so much the big focus right now. It's going to be communication issues, things going on with siblings, things going on with neighbors. And if you can, pursuing some of, like, projects and hobbies that you're kind of passionate about, maybe reuniting with old friends from high school or elementary school, that kind of thing it's big during a third house transit. And so getting to know your neighborhood, taking short trips, enjoying the environment. Now this weekend I'd say lay low, Friday, Saturday, you know, moon's in the 12th house for you, so, you know, all the lunatics and all the karma. You know, good time to, like, keep a dream journal, though. But, hey, come Sunday, Monday, moon will be in Leo. You'll be rocking in the free world, so to speak, and doing your fluffed up Leo thing. I know, I shouldn't have said fluffed up. Okay, welcome Virgo, welcome to your horoscope. So, I mean, you can surrender all responsibility now. You know, that overly responsible, service-oriented Virgo, Earth sign, you are now relieved of responsibility. Mercury is direct. Maybe Mercury's in your sign, so you're thinking good. You know, your thinking's clear. What does Libra symbolize for you? Well, it's the second house. And the second house is a lot like family, too. It's not so much maybe direct. It's also family around your family, your family's friends. It's possessions. It's things that affect your values. It's your voice. It's your throat. It's your neck. And your teeth and lower jaw and things like that. That's ears, hearing, all of this. So it ruled by the second house, so that's, you know, where you want to expand your health, your well-being. And Venus moves in the third house. So Venus in the third house makes me think more like hobbies, lighthearted kind of love affairs with friends. But, you know, music, working on songwriters, love this transit. just also kind of like extending more love in your neighborhood, you know, just more... Just like, hey, you know, I appreciate that, and, you know, being critically complimentary, being that uplifter, that's kind of Virgo. You don't have to be the, you know, the person that's so smart you know what's wrong with the world. My God, do we really need one of those? Okay, in defense of themselves, oh boy, here we go. Now to sports. No. Oh well. Sorry. Greetings, Libra. Welcome to your horoscope. So, hey, happy birthday. This is your time of renewal. I mean, we're in that waning moon period, so there's sort of a wind down from what's happened the last several weeks. But you got Jupiter in the first house. I mean, I would not, you know, even if you are Vedic Virgo or sidereal, you know, it's still Jupiter. You know, the thing I've heard from some of my teachers, and I think this is very legit, is that overall, Jupiter and Venus, no matter what sign they're in, they're good signs, okay? They're going to do something good for you. What I will say also, though, is some of you, not too many of you are going to respond well to both. Some of you are going to get better results from Venus. Others of you are going to get better results from Jupiter. For more of that, come see me. But in the meantime, you know, and this means time of birth and all that stuff. Meanwhile, back on the astrology ranch, we're having this transit of the sun moving into Libra in the autumnal equinox, and this is when, you know, the sun's rays start shining directly on the southern hemisphere and give us long shadows, especially, you know, if you're 40 degrees north or further, you notice it. You're like, oh my gosh, darkness is coming, you know. And you know, folks in Atlanta and LA, it's not that bad, okay? Yeah, it's not. You don't know. And if you're further south than that, yeah, you're completely out of it. Okay. So, I mean, I think what happens is the end of the week, you know, Thursday or whatever, moon will finally be in Libra, you'll be doing good. Venus now in the second house, you find a voice. And you enjoy food and cooking, and it's easy to want to spend money on luxury items. That's huge. But you know, there's some unpredictable element with your spouse. It's not like all the time, but it's that Uranian thing. You know, Uranus has been floating around in the seventh house forever. And so in relationships, there's just a lot of sometimes great inspiration, sometimes, oh my gosh, I can't believe it. They just shocked me. Look at what they did. Oh my God, they just bought another puppy. No, please. You know, it's that kind of thing. Okay. There's nothing wrong with puppies. I hear you. You know, you'd like to own every puppy in the world, especially the fluffy, cute ones on YouTube videos. All right. Greetings, Scorpio. Welcome to your horoscope. Yeah, I mean, it's the horoscope. I mean, this is... No, it's the 12th house transit. So, I mean, in the 12th house, we have to face our karma. And the worst part is we can be part of our own undoing. The best part is you know your own weaknesses so much that instead of trying to hide them and pretend that we don't know about them, be more transparent with them. Say, yeah, you know, you're right about that. I need to improve this. That was this. Okay. So, you know, there's nothing wrong with it. Okay, so let's talk about where you're going this week. So we've got Tuesday morning. It's earlier than that. No, it's today, right? Friday, the 23rd. You wake up and Venus is in your first sign, and at 7:51 a.m. that means you are too sexy for your shirt. I mean, this is Venus in Scorpio or Vedic Libra. When you put it in those terms, you know, it's about juicy, comma, love and sensuality, baby. And it's fertile too. You know, for couples trying to conceive more, I think water signs, you know, in Western astrology anyhow, is fertile. There's a fertility, or even just in your own mind for creative concepts. Everybody's going to get off on this, you know. If your key phrase is, I create Scorpio, it's going to be good. You know, and then there's Mars, you know, because your Mars ruled, as well as Pluto. So Mars ruling over into Capricorn along with Pluto. So like Pluto and Mars together, there's a strength, you know. You have a strength that's going to be seen in your communication. It's going to be seen among friends. It's going to be seen in your neighborhood. And you can transform things for good during this time. That's what we want. Transforming things for good. Hello, Sagittarius. Welcome to your horoscope. Okay. So this is kind of a really socially relevant year and a socially relevant time, because Libra rules your 11th house. 11th house is socializing. But because of that socializing, now Venus is going in your 12th house. So there's karma with love. You know, you thought it was a secret affair. Everybody knows it, but it's a secret to you. That's cool. We're cool with that. We all know that. We're laughing. You know, it's like a King of the Hill with Dale Gribble's wife or whatever. You know, it's just, everybody knows, but nobody can say anything. You know, just, you know. You know, there goes John Redcorn. Yeah. I can't even. Redcorn is actually really good. So, this week's shift of Mars leaving your first house, going into your second house. I mean, I always think of Mars in the second house as getting the right tools for the right job. There's also less urgency in your life. There's a lot more urgency all spring and summer, you know, with Mars, and I think you're finally kind of like, oh, okay, I can let this rest a little bit. And you're able to reap the good fortune of your friends. You know, I think that's the best thing about this week. I think your more lucky days are going to be Sunday and Monday this week. We can go with that. Hello, Capricorn. Welcome to your horoscope. Okay, so. So Jupiter now is in your midheaven. That's the 10th house. This is a good place to be. Are you trying to get a new job? Are you trying to up your career? Man, you better be doing it now. You should hit the ground running this week and the next several days, because showing off your good qualities, it's here. Now, as of Tuesday, Mars is in your first house. If you've been feeling lethargic, not motivated, all of that is changing. It's time for you to be strong. It's time for you to be fearless, courageous. And, I mean, I'm calling out the Capricorns that are real warriors for the Earth, you know, people that want to bring ecological Earth justice. Because I'll tell you, folks, we don't have a planet. We don't get anything else extra. You know, everything else just frills without a planet. And it's true. No, I know there's all kinds of injustice and discrimination and whatever, you know. A lot of times those things are used to let the government manipulate you into building them up into being bigger powers. Real justice comes by being a loving person, first to yourself and then extending it out to others. Remember that. So don't get caught up, but do your thing. Be courageous, because you're going to get her done. And this weekend looks good for romance, especially tonight, Saturday. It looks like you could make some sparks fly. Well, hello, Aquarius. All right, welcome to your horoscope. So, why did I do that? You know, this is a good time for you. This is like Libra time, time of luck and good fortune. It's the ashram. It's the higher way to go. And so a lot of this transformation and more depressing, icky stuff, it's all lifting up. You know, you do not have to worry. You don't have to stick around in the past. Everything's going to be incredible. You're going out with a bang. And, you know, the next stage is going to be good fortune. And so, you know, your social life's been good. I mean, the thing right now is with Pluto and Mars in the 12th house, there's some unbridled rage in your subconscious that you really got to find a healthy way to deal with. And I mean, it's going to be different for women than for men overall, and you know, and for those in between, the chemical mix, okay? And I see this as a time for at least, you know, Aquarius men, you know, might want to get that baseball bat and a tire and beat the tire up, you know, so nobody gets beat up in this kind of period of frustration. Next weekend, new moon, a lot of things are going to lift up for you. A lot of things are going to be luckier than ever. So I think it's just kind of like relax, breathe, and welcome good things happening. Welcome a higher philosophy that makes you feel better. Well, hello, Pisces. Welcome to your horoscope. This is it, you know? I mean, we had this nice relationship, diplomatic, easy feeling when Virgo was in your seventh house transiting. But now it is a eighth house transit time, which is transformation, and it's allowing other people to help you. And there is a lot of help out there for you right now. And so, and I mean, this is a time where you're likely to get inheritance, do good at yard sales, your ability to understand things like astrology and the occult and principles behind magic, numerology, they're gonna come to you. You're going to be able to digest it a lot more, with more ease. Now, the thing is you're not going to be in control of most of this stuff. And so there's an element of surrender. You're pretty good at that. But, I mean, don't just, like, swim around. Still sail your ship. It's a sweet weekend for you. With the moon in your fifth house, you're going to have a lot of fun. And then maybe Sunday, do more of the cleanup and the resting and, you know, taking care of yourself. And, you know, just pray, meditate, take it to the spirit place. This is where we need to go. We need all the extra help we can get. It's Kozmic Kev with your cosmic forecast. I look forward to being with you next week. Did I tell you, Pisces, you're going to be doing great, you know, with Venus as well and Scorpio? It's going to bring on an exotic look at love. And all of us here, we can benefit from these new changes. You know, your male friends are going through a lot of changes, Pisces. We see that too. Don't worry, you can handle this. And communication gets better in relationships this week as well with Mercury direct. Hey, it's been a joy. It's been love. Let's all do it again next week. Next forecast, Planetary Persuader, folks, with me, Kozmic Kev.